All right, what's up everybody? So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to use vidIQ. I'm gonna show you step by step. I'm actually gonna optimize a video right now so you can see exactly how I do it. And vidIQ, if you don't know, it's just a download. It's like a plugin type of thing that you must have if you're a video marketer, because YouTube is too competitive right now to just like put out just random videos that aren't optimized. So it has like a checklist and it's super helpful to get videos optimized. So the first thing you do, go to your videos. So this is the video I'm about to optimize right now. It's just kind of like there. There's no thumbnail. The title is not very good. So I'm going to click on it. It's actually going to start playing. So I'm going to pause that. And then I'm going to do edit video. So here we are. This is like behind the scenes of YouTube if you've never done a YouTube video. So what you're looking for is this right here. VidIQ score. So you want to have like 50 out of 50 before you release it. And actually, so you want to just kind of go through each thing and make sure you have it like tag content, keywords and title, at least one card. I actually just added a card. So I'll show you the first thing is you want to add cards. So those are the little things that pop up that link to other videos that you have.
All right, what's going on, everybody?
So here's an example of a card. It just links to other videos. And I have a card template saved, so I just load that up. But if you want to see what a card looks like.
It's about the real estate industry. Now, as far as this book goes.
Self-explanatory. It'll pop up, so it'd be like that. How much do housekeepers make? So I just put my three best videos. And I like to space them out a little bit. And cards, you know, it's not going to make, like, a massive difference. But it'll help. It'll definitely help. And you can do all five. I just do three. It seems to work pretty well. So. Now we'll go back to info and settings. So we have at least one card. Now we're going to do end screen. And as we start to do this, this will start to fill up a little bit more. So at least one end screen. So end screens are just, if someone watches the rest of your video, you should have a link for them to subscribe as well as to watch other videos. You can even have social media things. There's different ways of doing it. So I like to add my most recent upload. And I'm just basing this off a big YouTuber said just to do this strategy. So I'm like, all right, that works. Might as well copy him. Subscribe button. And then I like to do another video, best for viewer. So I have two videos. And this shows up, you see the last 20 seconds of the video. So that's when it's going to show up. And you can do a fourth video if you want. I just do three. Not a huge deal. So we'll save that. And then we'll go back to info and settings. And as you can see, now we have at least one end screen. So the number is going to be getting better. Closed captionings. So I use a service for closed captionings. I use a service called rev.com. And you just basically put the link of your YouTube video, and it costs like $1 per minute. So this video is like 10 minutes, so it cost me $10. And they'll have somebody that'll do the closed caption. So once that's ready, I'm gonna download that. And it's closed captionings are good because it's good for SEO purposes. So if you just have the Google YouTube automated text, it's not gonna be as accurate as if you have someone actually like doing closed captions for you. Monetization enabled, I probably won't do that. Add it to a playlist. So once I publish it, make it public, there's just an option to put it on a playlist. So I'll do that, make public, obviously, and then share on Facebook, share on Twitter, reply to recent comments. So these are just sharing it. Now is the time to go through the vidIQ SEO score. So for this video, sell it like Sirhant. This is about Ryan Sirhant, the real estate agent. So I'm gonna head over to vidIQ. And I'm going to sign in. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to start keyword research. So YouTube keyword research is a little bit different than Google keyword research, but I'm just going to type in like Ryan Sirhant, and then I'm going to type in things like he's going to have like $1 million listing. So these are going to be some of my keywords. And it's good because it has like how much search volume. It probably doesn't get 600,000. Probably not 100% accurate, but search score. So you want a good overall score. And you want to still be make sure it's accurate. So some of this, like I'm not going to put in NBC News. And honestly, I don't even care if it's that competitive, because I like going into super competitive niches and just optimizing it better, because if it's super competitive, it means a lot of people are searching it, obviously. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to make a list of Ryan Serhant million dollar listing, those types of related keywords, and then I'm going to add all those keywords into tags below. So I'm going to get about 15 really good keywords that I like, and then we'll go from there. So the first one, I'll probably just do Ryan Serhant. As you can see, now we're at 9.5 all of a sudden. Keywords and title, tag value. I'll probably do million dollar listing. That might even get a little bit better. But basically, I'm going to go through, I'm going to add 15 keywords, and then the score should be a little bit better. And then we're going to come up with a title, a better title, and then a better description. All right, so I just added about 15 or 20 keywords, as you can see right here. I filled it up basically to about 500. So you don't want to just put in like five keywords. You might as well use up the entire amount. So I did different keywords around Ryan Serhant, sell it like Serhant, million dollar listing, how to be a real estate agent, sales training, Grant Cardone, things like that. So different things that people could be searching. And as you can see, when we go down here, the vidIQ score is going up. Now it's at 22 out of 50. We're still at 2 and 9 on the checklist, but we'll get a lot higher. It's still looking for keywords in the description, triple keywords, keywords and title, tag volume and tag count are already good. And what's cool about vidIQ actually is it will give you suggested keywords. I already have enough keywords, but if I was looking for some more, it'll tell you, you know, videos to gain views from and different things like that. So it's pretty helpful. Okay, so the next thing we need to do to really boost this, we need to put in the description. Now, if you don't have a good video description, it's not going to get picked up in YouTube very well. So what I like to do, I have a template that I've saved that I use pretty much all the time. And then, you know, for different videos, obviously I'll change it, because you need to put some of these keywords in the description to get views. But I have a basic outline that I pretty much got from other YouTubers. I looked at what they were doing and I did a similar one. Now I just have my outline, and then I'll just fill it in with similar or with, you know, the content, this type of content. So I'm basically going to copy and paste, and then I'll probably write, this video is about a book review and 10 things I learned from Sell It Like Serhant, the book. So I'll probably copy paste the outline, and then I'll come up with the 10 things that I learned, and then I'll add, you know, these different keywords into the 10 things that I learned. And it's going to take me about 5 or 10 minutes to do that. So I'm just going to come back and then copy and paste it. Once I do that, you'll see my vidIQ score going way up. It might even be at 50 out of 50. I still need to do the title. I still need to come up with a really optimized title, but we're about to be there. So give me a second and I will get that up. Okay, so I just came up with my description, and I'm going to paste it right into here. And then you're going to see this. This was at 22, and it'll take probably a second to load. It's probably going to shoot up a lot. I need to just space this out a little bit better, so give me a second here. Just put some spaces in between here. Problem is, most people don't fill out these descriptions very well on YouTube, when in reality, you know, you should almost make this like a blog post. You should put some SEO, some keywords. And so what I'm actually going to put a vidIQ affiliate link right below this. So in your YouTube videos, you should have links to different things. I have links to like social media and stuff like that. And I'm also going to get an affiliate link, because this service is awesome. Like, you should definitely get it. I mean, if you're a video marketer, you're crazy if you don't use a service like this. There's similar ones, but vidIQ is great. Let me save the changes and I think it'll update it. So I think it's just a little lagging behind, but now I'm gonna do, now I need to come up with a title. And you know, the way I come up with titles, because titles are super important, the way I come up with titles is by looking at other YouTubers. So I might go on YouTube and I might look at someone like, let's say, Ty Lopez. You wanna look at the top YouTubers and you wanna see kind of like how their titles look, and then do a similar title. you never want to copy anybody. But I'm gonna probably, what I'm probably gonna do is spend a few minutes. I'm probably gonna browse. These are some of the channels. Grant Cardone, Daryl Eves, Project Life Master. I'm probably gonna browse around some of those channels, come up with a good title, and then put a keyword or two in the title, and then that'll be my title. And I also have to do a custom thumbnail too. So we're almost there. Okay, so here is the title I came up with, Sell It Like Sirhan Book Review, Ryan Sirhan, 10 Things I Learned. So I have his name in there, kind of twice, 10 Things I Learned. It's pretty clear. It's not too long of a title. And as you can see, my vidIQ SEO score is like almost at 50 out of 50, which like nobody ever does. So now I'm just going to do a few. I still need to add closed captionings, which I'm about to do. But that's pretty good. You know, it doesn't always have to be 50 out of 50. You know, I could add like another tripled keyword, but as long as it's pretty close, that's all I really care about. So next, I'm actually going to come up with a custom thumbnail. So I use fiverr.com to come up with thumbnails. And I just look at what other people use for thumbnails and then use one of those. So let's see. So which one should we go with? That one's kind of cool. I like this one. Kind of stands out. So we're going to upload that. So that should be, that'll help it. Now we need to add the closed captioning. So I'm going to go over to rev.com. So right now, YouTube will just publish automatic captions, which are not the best. It's like kind of auto-generated, so it's not great. So as you can see here, here's some of the ones I've done. So Sell It Like Sirhan's complete. I'm just gonna download it, and then I'm gonna upload it to YouTube. Download. I like to download it. I don't include text stamps. A TXT file, download. Sell It Like Sirhan.txt. Back here, add new subtitles, English. We're almost done optimizing it. This will make your videos do really well, trust me. Upload a file. So, transcript. There we go. I upload that, and then you actually have to delete the other, and I like to space it out a little bit. So I'm just gonna add a couple. I don't know if this makes a big difference, but just for my OCD, I guess it just looks better. So give me a second. I'm just gonna space it out. And what you want to do, I actually have a virtual assistant that does all this for me, that I've just trained to do all the optimization. So because this can take like a half hour, maybe longer. So if you train someone to do it, it'll save you a lot of time. You can do more videos, more content. But I just did it just for the purpose of this video. Okay, so I spaced it all out. Now I'm gonna do set timings. Just gonna do that. And then the automatic ones, you actually wanna click on this and you actually wanna delete those ones. So I'm gonna do unpublish. So now, and then now these are the ones that we just uploaded. So I'm gonna save those changes. It's kind of confusing. The automatic, you just don't want to use. All right, published English. Now we're going to go back. And we should just about be done. I'm actually going to make it live on this video. Pretty exciting. I'm going to publish it. So sometimes I already uploaded the thumbnail, but sometimes it doesn't show, but not a big deal. So we're pretty good, 43 out of 50. I'm about to add it to a playlist and I'm about to make it public. Sometimes I'll share it on Facebook and Twitter. But yeah, we're basically super optimized. Nobody does this type of optimization, very few people. So let's make it public. So we'll do public and then add to a playlist. I'll just do this one. Actually, you know what, I'll do reviews, that makes more sense. And you can put it in multiple playlists, but you wanna try to sort your playlists a little bit. And now it just went to 43 out of 100. So once you make it public, then it goes up to out of 100, but it takes a while for it to kick in. So that score will probably go up a bit. Yeah, I think we are good to publish it. Man, I always get a little nervous right before I publish it. Publish. And we are live. Now to see if it's published. I always upload all my videos as unlisted first, but now that's public. So you can see this is unlisted. That's public now. So there we go. It's live. So that's how you use vidIQ. I would highly recommend using vidIQ. It's an amazing tool. You can train people how to use it. It's inexpensive. And what I'm going to do, I put in affiliate link in this video, so you can use my affiliate link to set up your vidIQ, because you definitely should use it. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Please like. Please sign up for vidIQ using my link. And I'll see you on the next one. All right. Bye.